present Doctor at Large. Adapted for radio by Ray Cooney from the original novel by Richard Gordon, it stars Richard Briers as Simon Sparrow and Jeffrey Sumner as Sir Lancelot Spratt, with this week's special guests, Dan DeNichols as the old lady and Bill Fraser as Mr. Smith. Episode 1, The Deep End.
Come in. Ah! Sparrow, Benskin, Evans, come in. Shut the door, you horrible lot.
Morning, sir.
Shut up!
Lovely weather, sir.
Shut up, Sparrow.
Oh, terribly sorry, sir. It's just that we're so jolly pleased to see you after the Holes.
Holes?
Or holidays, Sir Lancelot. Yeah,
thank you, Evans.
Well, Holes is a simple abbreviation.
You'll get abbreviated if you don't shut up, Sparrow. Now, gentlemen, I use the word loosely.
I thought he used the word gentleman.
Benskin.
Terribly sorry, sir.
Yes. Last term is your final one at St. Swithin's Medical School, and you now stand before me as qualified doctors.
Oh, that was only due to your superb instructions, Sir Lancelot.
Oh, thank you, Evans, thank you.
Oh, don't mention it, sir.
Yes, you're on the threshold of your new careers. I'd like to say you'll be a credit to your profession.
Thank you very much.
I'd like to say that. All I can say, however, is that you're the most idle, insolent trio I've ever had through my hospital.
Flatterer.
I've been studying your applications for the various vacant posts here at St. Swithin's, and I see that both you, Evans, and Sparrow have applied for the appointment of junior casualty house surgeon to the professor of surgery.
Well, that's right, sir. Well, you do have two, don't you, sir? I mean, there's always been two on junior casualty.
You and Sparrow work as a double actor?
Well, no, sir, it's just that...
You've fallen in love with each other?
Oh, yes, sir. I know, sir, no. We both just fancy...
Fancy what?
The idea of working with you, sir.
You damn liar. You realize, do you, that only one of you will win promotion to senior house surgeon?
Fully realize that, sir?
After 3 months, I decide which junior stays with me as senior house surgeon and which one is thrown out to wail on some other hospital's doorstep.
Well, I'm sure Taffy and I realize that only one of us can pull it off, sir. I mean, friendly rivalry and all that, you know. May the best man win, rally since with him, tend to make...
Why have you put in for junior house surgeon, Sparrow?
Why, sir? Well, sir, because I want to specialize. I want to become a surgeon.
God, help us all.
Well, I don't really fancy the idea of general practice.
You don't? Backbone of the profession?
Well, I know that, sir, but nowadays, with the National Health Service and all that, a GP is likely to drop dead at 30 through overwork.
I can't help feeling that's a slight exaggeration, Sparrow.
Well, quite frankly, sir, I feel I've got the makings of a first-class one.
I couldn't agree more. First-class what?
Surgeon, sir. I did extremely well in first year zoology, sir, cutting up the jolly old dogfish and the jolly old frogs.
Now you don't shut your jolly old trap, are we? And you, Evans.
Sir?
I suppose you also feel you have the makings of a first-class one.
Oh, definitely, Sir Lancelot, but that's only due, of course, to your excellent instruction and ever-friendly guidance.
Well, yes, all right, all right. Now then, let me see. Very well, the pair of you are appointed. Report to casualty.
Great,
oh,
good old Taff.
Good old Simon Boyle.
Put him down, Evans, put him down. The honeymoon can wait.
Oh, sorry, sir.
Now, Benskin, I see that you've applied to be Mr. Frost's junior.
Yes, sir.
Obstetrics, eh? Would you say maternity was your line, Benskin?
You've got to be joking, sir.
Sparrow! Well, Benskin?
Well, I think so, yes, sir. I fancy it. But no, I'd like to get some maternity benefit. There's just some...
Shut up and report to Mr. Frost at 10 o'clock.
Yes, sir. Simon, how's it going?
Oh, hello, Tony. I'm absolutely fed up and whacked.
Oh, you would go in for surgery, old love?
What's this lot got to do with surgery?
Well, I don't know, quite a pleasant little place for a casualty room. Bit chilly.
Chilly? I feel like Scott of the Antarctic.
You know, I don't think your get-up will actually inspire confidence in the patients.
What do you mean?
Wellington boots, duffel coat and a balaclava. No.
I'm freezing, wretched place.
It's got what they call old world charm.
Yeah, looks like a cross between a public laboratory and an air raid shelter. Look at that examination couch. Look at that sterilizer. Look at these instruments.
This is pretty ancient.
Even the nurses in casualty look as though they're due for the old age pension.
But it's hard luck, I must say. So you don't think you're cut out for surgery?
Cut out for...
Did I tell you the one, the one about the surgeon who had his girlfriend in stitches?
No.
Well, that's it.
What is?
Oh, maybe you shouldn't have gone in for surgery after all.
Surgery? I'm nothing more than a pen pusher, a form filler in her.
Well, I've never seen so many forms.
I know. I can't pass a patient on until the correct ones are filled in.
Well, you must be getting pretty good at diagnosing, then.
Not really. The porter diagnoses all the difficult ones.
Yeah. Well, don't be downhearted. At least you're working with Taffy. Where is he?
Don't talk to me about that nasty little Welsh leek.
Well, aye, aye.
He has changed.
Has he? You better send him to me at maternity.
I wouldn't have believed it of him.
Oh, poor old Taffy. What's he done? I thought you loved him.
I never realised he was so damned ambitious, I'll tell you that.
Now, come on, be specific, old love.
Taffy has become a crawler.
A crawler?
He knows full well that only one of us can get promotions, so he spends his entire life sucking up to Fanny Spratt.
Oh, no, no, it's your imagination, Simon.
It certainly isn't. What's more, he pinches patients.
Pinches patients?
Yes, he's a patient pincher. In his lunch break, he wanders around stopping people in the street with promising warts and boils.
what does he do that for?
He gives them his card and tells them to ask for him personally since Swithin's casual.
I see.
But it's not fair, is it? Touting for business. I feel such a fool with all these road menders and taxi drivers and news vendors streaming in and telling me they only want to be handled by Dr. Evans.
Filthy beast. Now, doesn't seem all that serious, old love. I mean, he's just getting some practice in.
That's not the point. It's not the thing to do. I wouldn't have expected it from Taff. And he usually ends up by not only removing their lumps, but also their bad teeth and ingrowing toenails as well.
If you're so upset about it, why don't you pop out and collect a few juicy boils?
Because it's not considered etiquette. Come in.
Excuse me, young man.
Oh, can I help you?
Yeah, I was told to come here by the porter.
Yes.
You casualty?
Yes, most certainly.
Good.
Now, oh, well, don't have to tell me what your trouble is, old girl. you've banged your poor old nose, haven't you?
My nose?
Yeah, someone's fished it a right fourpenny one, haven't they? you'd better lay off the fisticuffs.
Lay off the fisticuffs?
Well, only teasing. Door smacked it, did it?
Wow. Nothing smacked it. It's not my nose I've come about.
Isn't it? It's bright red.
Bright red? So was that colour.
Oh. Oh, well, in that case, you'd better...
Lay off the booze.
Yes, you'd better... Will you shut up? It must be the cold weather, that's it. The cold weather is enough to freeze the... yes, well... what can I do for you, madam?
Nothing, thank you.
Well, you must have something wrong with you or you wouldn't be here.
Yes, I have. But I'm seeing my own personal physician in casualty, Dr. Evans.
Dr. Evans?
Lovely lad. We got chatting in that cafe across the road over a cup of tea. I told him about my boil.
Charming.
Madam, I am on duty at the moment.
That's all right. I don't mind waiting.
You needn't wait. I'll attend to you right away.
No, I'd rather not. Dr. Evans explained you'd only just passed out.
How kind of him. Well, as this is Dr. Evans' lunch break, I'll see to you.
But Dr. Evans...
Now, sit down. Sit down, please. That's it. Thank you. Now, what's the trouble? A boil, you say?
That's right.
Now, right. Where is it?
I'm sitting on it.
I beg your pardon?
It's on a...
Yeah, I see what you mean. I know. I know. Well, you'd better stand up then, hadn't you? Go behind that screen.
What can I wait for Dr. Evans?
But because I say you can't. Now, behind that screen and get your underclothes off.
Hey?
You heard.
Yeah, look, it's quite all right, Mrs.
Mrs. Muir.
Yeah, well, it's quite all right, Mrs. Muir. You see, I'll be a witness.
Witness? Witness to what?
Look, just get the things off, will you?
Dr. Sparrow has had a very busy day, Mrs. Muir. I promise you he's a very able doctor.
Who are you, then? You look about as able as he does.
Take your knickers off.
I want to know who he is, if he's going to hang about witnessing my backside.
This is Dr. Benskin.
Never heard of him.
Yeah. I'm in maternity.
I'm going home.
Come back! Come back! I'll get behind that screen.
All right. All right. Crippin'.
You see, Tony, that's the sort of thing I have to put up with all the time.
Here, this screen's got holes in it.
It doesn't matter.
Not peeking, are you?
Can't take our eyes off you. Come on, hurry up. Get on with it.
All right. Got them off.
Oh.
I'm ready.
Right.
Still think I should wait for Dr. Evans?
Look, never mind about Dr. Evans. Just lie on the table, face down.
Oh, it's not right when I come here of my own free will.
Now, I'll just lift your dress up.
Oh, God, your hands are cold.
Look, madam, if you could just stop talking for a minute while I examine your boil.
She's got a bit of a cheek, hasn't she?
Shut up. Sir? Nothing, nothing, nothing.
We were just having a consultation.
That's it.
The soda milk, shouldn't have thought. It's plain for anyone to see.
It certainly is. pass me the knife, will you, Tony?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.